Only I did, but no, right, Nelson, no, ST, Thayer Jr., well. we're a 50-50 team.
Excuse me. but I'm asking, it seems like Philadelphia is kind of the focal point of these type of cases right now, and I was wondering if this is going to be a specific focus for your office moving forward.
I don't know there's a specific focus. I think that whenever we have evidence of wrongdoing, we pursue it. So I don't know if there's a specific focus. I think that there's a large West African population here, immigrant population here, and so if there are people who were involved in the conflict who have made false statements when they in fact were trying to get immigration benefits with them, and we know about them, those are the sorts of things we'll pursue based on the evidence.
And have you been getting any calls from other attorneys in other districts across the country who also have large librarian?
No, we've gotten congratulatory emails from other prosecutors across the country who've read about the case, but I haven't had any contact with anyone who has specifically called us.
I'm from Liberia. I'm just wondering what drives you to do these kind of cases.
Nelson? I have to say, when we were waiting for the verdict, Dr. King's words about the arc of the moral universe being long but bending towards justice came to mind. And I couldn't help thinking that that arc started in Liberia and it touched down in Philadelphia today.
And I understand this is your second case of this nature. So should we expect more cases in the pipeline?
What
specifically do you like in Civil War or other wars?
We really can't comment on whether or not there are any other investigations. If cases are presented or we have evidence of similar fraud, we will look at those. So,
thank you.
Can you talk at all about what sort of sentence he may be looking at in comparison to Jabate based on the charges that
we don't know that.
Gotcha.
We don't know that. That's something that we're going to have to go back to the office and talk about what our recommendation will be. Mm-hmm. We have a different case.
Do you think it would be more or less? You're not even prepared to go there quite yet?
Gotcha. I don't know. We have to sit down and reflect upon it and take a look.
Can you tell us about a parole to you? I mean, is he on parole, house arrest?
About him being on house arrest?
Yeah. You say he was out on bail, right?
He's out on bail now.
Okay.
But he'll be confined under certain conditions to his home.
What about assets?
Pending the appellate process, I guess. I think the judge said pending appeal. I don't know what, when she sentences him, I don't know whether she'll immediately remand him. That certainly is an option that she has at the time of sentencing, is to immediately remand him, or she can let him stay out on bail, out under house arrest until the appellate process runs its course. It's up to her.
What about assets? What about his assets?
I don't, that wasn't part of our investigation and prosecution.
And so there were five not guilty counts?
I only heard the guilty ones, so I, were there five?
Our count was 11 guilty and five not guilty.
Okay, well we're pleased with the verdict.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We're pleased with the verdict. And we're particularly pleased that all of the accounts that related to persecution were in fact guilty verdicts.
And the TLC report became a big issue in this.
Yes.
For the defense, anyway.
Yes.
Is this does this say anything about the TLC report and the point was that the TLC report exonerated Ruiz?
Well, the TLC report really didn't exonerate him. And that was one of the things that we argued during our closing argument, that in fact the TRC report supported and underscored our case, in that we contended that he, among other things, advocated for the overthrow of a government by force or violence, and that he persecuted in his role as Minister of Defense. And the TRC report, in fact, recognized that. So that was a defense strategy. I didn't understand it. I think that the jury rejected it.
You've been back and forward to Liberia
in
the last few years.
Yes.
is there some message that you have for the Liberian people from that?
Well, I think it's probably the same message we had after Jabate, is that we hope that some of them find some solace in this and understand that there are people who in fact care about their experience and want to see them have justice. And we hope that, that we've helped that cause today.
And what about the witnesses who came from Liberia to speak?
I can't say enough. We can't say enough about the witnesses. They were brave, brave, brave witnesses who came here. They came here because they were aggrieved and they wanted justice. And you know, we've said this before, that when people are abused and people don't feel like they have any redress, it has all sorts of effects that sort of cascade from that. And we are happy that hopefully there are people in Liberia today who will say that there is a chance for justice for us. That, you know, people just can't do whatever they want to us without some sort of consequence to them, some sort of legal consequence. And that's the way it should be.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.